Set against the backdrop of the proposed merger between PNM and a company called Avangrid, an ethics complaint against Attorney General Hector Balderas alleges he was too easily swayed by the lawyer for Avangrid when he voiced support for the settlement deal. Now, filed with three state agencies, the complaint says it's Mr. Balderas' relationship with Marcus Rael and his law firm that's getting in the way of his duty to be the lawyer for New Mexicans and to look out for their interests. The two are friends, but as Searchlight New Mexico and the Santa Fe Reporter have pointed out, Mr. Balderas' office has hired Mr. Rael's firm to represent the state for far more often than it's hired other law firms for far more money, too, as a matter of fact. And Diane, the watchdog groups who filed the complaint say even though Hector Balderas changed his mind when there was a better settlement offered, giving more money to ratepayers and impacted communities, he clearly left money on the table. Does this seem like a clear conflict to you?
Just with your statement, maybe not.
Okay.
But the whole, if you look at the whole scenario of it, instinct says, you know, there's something rotten in Denmark, so to speak. Mm-hmm. And it happens more often in New Mexico in state agencies or governmental agencies than I think we should be seeing. Mm-hmm. The only thing that I do think is you hear all the time, oh, well, look at the record. We did this, 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 and this. Well, that's true. You did follow all, and I did see that. We followed all the procurement code statutes. Mm-hmm. However, there is a thing called an RFP. And when you write, the agency requesting the services is the one writing the RFP. And you and I know that you can write that RFP to where it only one firm
That's
meets.
Right.
I mean, you could say like require 10, minimum 10 years of acting as legal firm for a governmental entity.
Right.
Well, that wipes out a bunch of people right there. So, but you can put those kinds of things, which are legitimate, into the RFP so that only the firm you want gets selected and does meet all the criteria. I think that in this case, regardless of what the real reasons are, and maybe there was no hanky-panky, the cynic in me says, but I think it's the appearance of evil is so strong in this case, particularly because our AG had been saying that this really wasn't a good deal for
That's
New
right.
Mexico.
That's right.
And then after these long meetings with his good friend, which, by the way, their law firm is a good law firm. But after that, those meetings, then he suddenly switched his position. That makes most of us very skeptical. And
I hear that. Let me ask Inez to get in on this too. You know, Inez, regulators in the AG's office are, you know, they're often looking at whether the balance of such deals, you know, as Diane's mentioning, tilts too much towards shareholders and away from ratepayers. But when you're sitting across the table, as Diane just mentioned, from an old law school buddy and a guy you've hired a bunch of times to work for you, how does that balance work? You know, protecting the ratepayers versus the shareholders' desires.
It's obvious that people trust folks they know.
Right.
And Avangrid PNM hired somebody that was known to the AG's office and probably a lot of other important New Mexicans, which is spending their money wisely, even if they did pay him, you know, double what he usually makes at the AG's office. The problem.
I want to make sure I understand what you're saying. It's in their better interest to work with someone that they know, even though it may cost them or the taxpayer double the amount?
Well, no, I'm talking about the private company.
Gotcha.
The private company hired somebody that they knew had an in at the AG's office.
Gotcha.
And it said in the reporting that he's getting double what he got from the AG's office from the private company. So he's making a lot of money,
right,
but they're getting access that they wouldn't get otherwise. And that's the problem, is he might be perfectly correct in his arguments. He might be making a great case. But the fact is that because he knows the attorney general and the attorney general knows him, and I don't know that just because they went to law school together, they're necessarily buddies. My husband has a million law school people that were his classmates that are not his friends. So who knows?
Right.
That part of it, that's kind of speculation. But what we do know is they had all those meetings, and afterward, Hector changed his mind. So what I think is this is another issue for, you know, our ethics commission, but also for our legislature. Can New Mexico have some sort of statute that says if you are paid by a state agency X amount of dollars within a year, you cannot lobby that same agency within a certain period of time? And that way they can't hire the guy who has connections to walk into his friend or colleague's office to sit down across the table. Mm-hmm. So I think this opens up a discussion about who do we want getting taxpayer dollars and then turning around and using that access to get private dollars. And can we stop that?
I love the way you put that last bit there. Serge, do pick up on that. That's, she left a good one there for you. That's for sure.
Well, I mean, I think, first of all, you're never going to hear me complain about people employing our graduates.
From UNM Law, that's right.
Of UNM Law, absolutely. But, you know, I mean, I think, obviously, you know, the optics of this are not great. Mm-hmm. And I get that. And while I don't want to take away from the question about ethics, I think it's an important one and sort of how we do this. And in a state like New Mexico, where people, you know, everyone knows everybody. It'd be an interesting question, like how do we address that and how do we do that? But I am also a little bit concerned that this is flaring up right now at a really important time for this merger as well, the hearings. Mm-hmm. And to say, you know, focusing on this with Hector Balderas it's not unimportant. I don't want to say that, but I do think, you know what, this merger is a huge thing for New Mexico. And the questions that are still out there, like that need to be resolved, such as what is the amount that's going to come to ratepayers? How is this going to be divided? Those are still open questions. Those are still things that need to be resolved. And so I want to also make sure that we focus on the actual meat of this, which is, you know, the actual deal is something that's going to affect every single New Mexican. And definitely the Balderas-Rael connection is part of that, but it's not the whole story. And we're approaching a really important point in these hearings.
I appreciate you saying that. That's an important point. Senator, I got a question for you. Would Mr. Balderas have been better off coming up with a policy that he could point to that would protect against the appearance, you know, of a conflict? Instead, his office called the complaint baseless. Does it seem baseless? I mean, is that the way to push it back to the public like that?
No, I'd like to just quickly to answer your question and to follow up on something Inez said. Mm-hmm. I like the idea.
Right, about a minute and a half, by the way. Sorry about that.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Like if the legislature could, in looking at our current laws, maybe to protect the public, you could say, okay, if a law firm or any other entity, but a law firm has done business with this agency in their defense, representing them in legal cases, representing the agency, the governmental agency, they may not for X years or whatever work for a company, private company, that is coming before the agency for help or a request for help.
Okay.
And that's a little scattered, but the idea is there. You don't have, because to me, the bad part is, here's the law firm that's been working for this state agency, for the attorney general.
Right.
And all of a sudden now he's working for the private entity in face of the attorney general. So maybe there is something that could be done along those lines. Sure. And I see Serge raising his hand there.
What do you think, Serge?
That raises some concerns for me because one of the bedrock principles of our profession is anybody should be able to choose whoever they want as their lawyers. And that applies to the state as well as someone else, right? You should be able to choose who you have representing you and advocating for your interests. And so I would be, the devil is always in the details, but, you know, limitations on who you can have as your lawyer there are a few situations where that applies, but it is, you know, something that I would be really wary of.
Real quick, Inez, go ahead.
So just real quick, I just wanted to follow up to what Serge said about the bigger issues. To me, the bigger issue, even more than shareholders versus stakeholders or ratepayers, is whether Avangrid purchasing PNM puts New Mexico in a better place to become a renewable energy state. Yeah. And is it better for the planet? I mean, you look at it, we're part of a big global climate crisis. Are we going to be better off with a really rich company that can invest in solar, et cetera, than we are with PNM?
Good point there.
And I don't know the answer, but that's the question we need to be asking.
That's right. And I remind, this is the only publicly traded company we have. This is kind of a big deal to get this right. That's for sure. We're out of time on this one.